Hello children, in today's class we are going to continue with the addition and subtraction word problem. Yesterday we have already done 2. I hope all of you were able to do at home. Shall we continue? Now read the question. There were 2,379 sacks of grains in a godown. Godown is the place where they store. Okay, they keep together. 4,320 more sacks were stored in it. So, first how much were there? 2,379 was there. Again, they have stored 4,320. Then, if 2,785 sacks were removed later, after some time, they removed 2,785. How many sacks would be there in the total? So, what we have to do? We have to add first and find out how many sacks they put there. Then, after what we have to do, we have to subtract how much they have removed. Alright. Shall we start doing? Yes. Now, what is the first statement? Number of grain sacks, or you can write number of sacks of grain is equal to 2,379. Then, what is this? What is this then? 4,380 more sacks were stored in it. Okay? Number of more sacks were stored is equal to 4,320. Shall we find out about that? So, we have to find out how many sacks are there now. So, total number of sacks of grain. Okay. What we have to do? We have to add these two. Find out the answer. 9 plus 0, 9. 7 plus 2, 9. 3 plus 3, 6. 2 plus 4. So, how many total number of sacks are there now? 6,699 sacks are there now in the godown. Now, everyone happened. If 2,785 sacks were removed, so how to write number of sacks of grain or sacks of grain? Sacks were removed. Is equal to how many children? 2,785. Okay, now what we have to do, how many sacks would be there in the godown? How many sacks would be there in the godown? So much is removed. Then, therefore, number of sacks. You can write answer this if you want. Okay, would be there in the godown, or number of sacks in the godown is equal to, subtract and write the answer, 9 minus 5, 4, 8, 9 minus 8, 1. Are we able to subtract? No, we have to go. Now, 16 minus 7, 9. 5 minus 2, 3. Now tell me, how many sacks of grains are left in the godown now? 3,914. Is it clear to them? One more is left, isn't it? That is all. Shall we do it now? Excellent. Okay, read it. Harish bought 1975 notes, notebooks from a bookseller and 2314 notebooks from another bookseller. Then he distributed 1329 notebooks to the needy students. How many notebooks are still with him? So what did he do? First he brought 1975 notebooks from a bookseller. Bookseller means a person who sells the book. Okay. Again what he did? He went to another bookseller and brought a 2314. And afterwards what he did? He has given 1329 notebooks to needy. So the some students were in it. So he has given 1329 notes to those students. Now what we have to find out? How many notebooks are still with him? After giving the students, what is the balance with him? Shall we do? Now, what is the student? 1975. So what is how to write the statement? Number of notebook Harish bought from a bookseller is equal to 1975. Then again what did he do? He bought it from another bookseller. So number of notebooks he bought it from subtract and see. Are we able to subtract 9 from 5? No, 5 is a small number. So what we have to do? We have to borrow from 10's place. So we have borrowed 1 from 10's place. Now 15 minus 9. 6. Now, are we able to borrow? Are we able to subtract 2 from 0 to 10? No, what we have to do? We have to borrow from 100's place. Now it is 10. 10 minus 2, 8. The same way you see here, we cannot subtract 3 from 2. We have to take borrow from 1000's place. Now 12 minus 3. 12 minus 3, 9. 3 minus 1, 2. Now tell me, children, how many notebooks are still with him? There are 2986. I hope these four problems are clear and you are able to do how to do it in your maths.